Hello guys, in the previous video we have created tile maps and custom tiles. Now in this video I will focus on creating a road tile that changes the sprite depending on the neighboring tiles, so the roads will connect seamlessly. Now finding neighboring tiles is going to be something we will be doing a lot during this project, so I decided to make things easier for us and add an extension for the vector tree int. And this way, I will be able to get the tiles to north, south, east, west, etc. with a single function. I will store this extension to the extensions folder and create a C# script. This will not inherit from anything and also has to be static. Since the class is static, anything in it will also be static. Now let's create our first function. This is north. This keyword indicates that I can call this function from any vector tree int and simply return a new vector to the north of it. I use right because our grid is organized in y, x, z order instead of standard x, y, z. Now you can change this from the grid if you want, but this is the default. Then we have the south. After that, we have the diagonal directions, which tend to be a bit more confusing. Now, the Unity tile maps organize hexagonal tile coordinates according to this. For example, the northeastern tile cannot always be found by simply adding one to the Y coordinate. As in the figure, if the Y coordinate is even, then we need to add one to X and one to Y coordinate to get the northeastern tile. So I simply check the value of the Y coordinate, and if it is even, I add or subtract 1 to the X coordinate. As long as the Unity do not change their coordinate system, this is working even with negative coordinates. I decided to rework these lines so that they wouldn't have issues with negative coordinates. Now we can return to the road tile. Now currently, road tile contains only the movement bonus and it inherits from the tile script of the Unity engine's tilemaps library. Now let's create a class to keep conditions for changing the sprite. We can create a list of bools to store the presence of roads on the sides. Since we are dealing with hexagons, there need to be only 6. And should all conditions are met, we will update the tile sprite. Now let's import our road sprites. Again, must remember to set the compression to none and filter to no filter, otherwise the sprites will look distorted. I will create a palette for the roads. But for this style, I will drag only one of the sprites. This will create a single tile object. Let's check if it's working. Next, I can change the script from the tile to row tile. I can do that if I set the inspector to the debug mode. I can see the movement bonus and rules variables now. We can set the conditions, but having these conditions as an array doesn't tell us which toggle corresponds to the which neighbor. So I'd rather change these into individual booleans. I can see the movement bonus and rules variables now. If there is road only in the corresponding direction, we want the tile to change its sprite. Let's get coding. First of all, we need a default sprite that we can fall back to if none of the conditions are met. After that, we will override getTileData function. And this function updates the tileData argument because it is given with a reference keyword. So even though the function returns nothing, still it leaves the tile data updated. So we'll do the same thing and update the sprite variable. Let's store the neighboring tiles first. After that, we need to iterate through the rules and check each. I want all 6 neighbors to match the conditions, so let's create an integer and add to it as we check. If at the end we get 6, that means all the neighbors are matched. And to do that, I prefer declaring a new function. Let's call it conditionCheck. If the toggle is true, and that there is a road on the given direction, the function will return 1. If the toggle is false, and there is no road in the given direction, that 2 will return 1. In any other situation, the function will return 0. Now check all directions. And if the old conditions of a rule are met, then we want to change the sprite and break the loop. There's no point iterating if we have one rule that is met. And finally, set the sprite of the tile data with our sprite. Now let's try what looks. I do not have sprites for all directions, so I will use the crossroad as my default sprite. Okay, let's enter the rules. It seems to be working nicely, but we want this modification to work during the gameplay as well. So let's make a test script that will create road during the gameplay. Now first, I will add another function to the extensions. This will return the neighbors as an array so that we can iterate through them much easily. Then create a test script and assign to a game object. We need the grid, the road map, and the road tile here. We will check for the mouse button in the update. If the left mouse button is down, then we will draw a road. If the right mouse button is down, then we will erase it. Since both conditions are doing something similar, we can do both of them in the same function. But the function doesn't exist yet. Let's rename this so what it does will be clear. Now I convert the mouse position to the world position, then the world position to the cell position. And then 0 to Z axis. And then set the tile at the location. If the erase boolean is false, we will add a road, but if it is true, then we will delete by setting it to null. And at the end, we need to refresh all tiles within the tile map. Let's assign the script to a game object and play. Works smoothly. Great. In the next video, I will code pathfinding for these hexagonal tile maps. So please subscribe to keep updated and have a nice day.